Now, Cara is a five-year-old border collie bitch. When she's not doing freestyle, she enjoys canicross, agility, and generally getting very muddy.
Uncle Gutenberg was a bookworm, and he lived on Charing Cross. The memory of his volumes brings a smile. He would read me lots of stories when he wasn't on the source. Now I'd like to share the wisdom of my favorite bibliophile. He said, cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook. Chapter titles are like signs, and if you read between the lines, you'll find your first impression was mistook. For a cover is nice, but a cover is not the book.
Mary Poppins, could you give us an example?
Certainly. Nellie Rubina was made of wood, but what could not be seen was though a trunk up top was barren, well her roots were lush and green. So in spring when Mr. Hickory saw her blossoms blooming there, he took root despite her bark, and now there's seedlings everywhere.
Which proves a cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook.
Chapter titles are like signs,
and if you read between the lines,
you'll find your first impression was mistook. For a cover is nice, but a cover is not the book.
Shall we do the one about the wealthy widow?
Oh, by all means.
Always loved that one.
Well, go on then.
Lady Hyacinth McCaw brought all her treasures to a reef,
where she only wore a smile,
plus two feathers and a leaf.
So no one tried to rob her, cause she barely wore a stitch.
But when you're in your birthday suit, there ain't much there to show you're rich.
Oh, a cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look.
Oh, give us the one about the dirty rascal, why don't you?
Once upon a time in a nursery rhyme, there was a castle with a king hiding in a wing, because he never went to school to learn a single thing. He had scepters and swords and a parliament of lords, but on the inside he was sad, egad, because he never had a wisdom for numbers, a wisdom for words, though his crown was quite immense, his brain was smaller than a bird's. So the queen of the nation made a royal proclamation to the misses and the messers, the more or lessers, bring me all the land professors. Then she went to the hairdressers, and they came from the east, and they came from the south, from each college they poured knowledge from their brains into his mouth, but the king couldn't learn, so each professor met their fate. But then suddenly one day a stranger started in to sing. He said, I'm the dirty rascal and I'm here to teach the king. And the queen clutched the jewels, for she hated royal fools. But this fool had some rules they really ought to teach in schools. Like, you'll be a happy king if you enjoy the things you've got. You should never try to be the kind of person that you're not. So they sang and they laughed when the king had found a friend. And they ran onto a rainbow for the story's perfect end. So the moral is, you mustn't let the outside be the guide, for it's not so cut and dried. No, the truth can't be denied, as I now have testified. All that really counts and matters is the special stuff inside.
Oh, a cover is not the book, so open it up and take a look. Cause under the covers one discovers that the king may be a crook.
So please listen to what we've said
and open a book tonight in bed.
So one more time before we get the hook,
sing it out strong.
A cover is not.
Please take her advice.
A cover is not. But a cover is not the book.
Helen Dennis and Cara there. Now, they've represented Great Britain several times in the past. How did they go on today, Richard?
Yes, they did very well. They were using those props very well today. And the props always got to be relevant to the routine. And it was a nice little surprise when the dog pulled out those penguins that you always think of when you think of Mary Poppins and you think of the film. And those little things there just set you apart. And when you're sitting there as a judge, you know, you want to be wowed. You want to really sort of be drawn into it. And, you know, that really was a lovely sort of light performance.
And it is that kind of showmanship that sets freestyle apart from heel work to music, isn't it?
It does. And team performance is obviously something that the judges are looking at. The costumes that the handlers are wearing, they should always be matched to the routine and should be not too sort of gaudy or anything like that, so it distracts from the dog. And I always say the better the dog you've got, the more outlandish you can be, a little bit more outlandish with your whole outfit. But it's all about presenting that picture of, you know, dog handler together and bringing that music to life.
I think they did that, and it looks like our judges have made their decision. So a couple of moments and we should have this result for you.
Yes, I think that might go a little bit ahead. You never know with the judges, but it could go a little bit ahead of the previous dog. Look at that already.
Yes.
9.2, 8.2 with an 8. Pamela obviously liked this one because look at that. She's gone for a 9.2 on accuracy, 8, 8. And a 9.3 for interpretation. 8.3. 8.4. Any deductions? That would just be if the dog made any noise. And, oh dear, I did hear a little bit of noise there. So they're just, the judges having to take a little bit off there. That's not a lot when they could take up to 4 marks. So 25.23 goes into the lead, as I thought it might.
So we've got another small dog here coming in that's hoping to put on a big performance. So as I was saying, we've got another small dog here hoping to put on a really big performance today. So this is Lucy Heath and Trip. This is a Pomeranian crossed with a Maltese, 5-year-old dog. And they're going to be performing to be our guests. Now, you may well recognise them because this is the dog they put, the song they performed to in the finals of Britain's Got Talent back in 2016.
Ma chère mademoiselle. It is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you tonight. And now, we invite you to relax, let us pull up a chair, as the dining room proudly presents your dinner. Be our guest, be our guest, put our service to the test. Tie your napkin round your neck, sherry, and we provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot hors d'oeuvre, why, we only live to serve. Try the grey stuff, it's delicious. Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, miss, this is France, and a dinner here is never second best. Go on, unfold your menu, take a glance, and then you'll be our guest. We our guest, be our guest. Beef ragout, cheese souffle, pie and pudding on flambé. We'll prepare and serve with flair a culinary cabaret. You're alone and you're scared, but the banquet's all prepared. No one's gloomy or complaining while the flatware's entertaining. We tell jokes, I do tricks with my fellow candlesticks.
Put it all in perfect taste that you can bear.
Come on and lift your glass, you've won your own free pass to be our guest.
If you're stressed, it's fine dining we suggest.
Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest.
Life is so unnerving for a servant who's not serving. He's not whole without a soul to wait upon. Ah, those good old days when we were useful. Suddenly those good old days are gone. 10 years we've been rusting, needing so much more than dusting. Needing exercise, a chance to use our skills. Most days we just lay around the castle. Flat, be fat and lazy. You walked in and oops-a-daisy.
It's a guest, it's a guest. Sakes alive, and I'll be blessed. Wine's important, thank the Lord. I've had the napkins freshly pressed. With this food, she'll want tea. And my dear, that's fine with me. While the cups do this, I'll shoo it. I'll be bubbling, I'll be brewing. I'll get warm, I'll be hot. For the sake of a spot, clean it up.
got a lot to do. Is it one lump or two for you, our guest?
He's our guest.
She's our guest.
He's our guest. He's our guest. He's our guest. He's our guest. He's our guest. I'm the man who's on the rest of his 10 years. We had anybody here, and we're obsessed. It's your deal, with your deals. Yes, indeed, we is the deal. While the candle lights do glow, let us help you with the golden boys. My
horse, one by one, till you shout,
enough, I'm done.
Then we'll sing you up to sleep as you digest.
You'll prop your feet up on the knowledge feet of the Arcades.
Lucy Heath and Trip there. Now, Lucy says she loves the end of that routine. It gets her every time. What do you think, Richard?
Yes, it was a lovely little surprise there with the dog coming out of the top of the cake. Trip, not an easy little dog to work. You know, sometimes he's just losing a little bit of drive now and again. But Lucy was working really hard there to keep him motivated. And there were some nice moments and good little jumps. This bit at the start where he rolled in the napkin there, which really brought an awe from the audience.
Yeah, they did seem really popular with the crowd, actually, so you can see why they did well on Britain's Got Talent.
Yes, he's a cute little dog. He's got a really lovely personality. But it is hard when you've got these smaller dogs. They sometimes don't have as much internal drive, say, as the Border Collie that we've just seen. And so you've really got to work hard. I've been out there with a little Chihuahua myself, and I can tell you those 4 minutes feel like 4 hours when you're out there. You're on your own, and it does feel a long time.
Lucy was certainly been very active herself there, wasn't she? She's had a good workout in that
yes,
ring.
Yes, and all that action that she was putting in it will motivate the dog. And it's all about keeping that dog motivated and happy. So looks like the scores are coming in.
Do you think we're going to have a new winner here?
I'm not sure. We'll have to see.
It must be so nerve-wracking for them, these few moments when they see the judges have decided and they're waiting for those scores to come up on the screen.
It is, but many of them will have rushed out the back there, and the first thing they're going to do is be rewarding that dog with either food or a toy. So a bit of a difference in score here from Kath, 6.9, 6.5 for her for accuracy. But the other judges up in the 8s and the 7s. So you can see how the personal opinion comes into it a little bit there, although they're all judging to the same rules. So I'm not sure that's going to go into the lead. Any barking deduction there? No. So it's into third place with 22.97.
That's a good score, and I think the top result they've ever had here at Crufts is 4th, so if they maintain that, then, you know, they're doing well. Next in the ring, we've got Carol Dodson with Brooklyn. Now, this is a 9-year-old Border Collie dog, and they're going to be performing to Dead Silence. This is their 4th year performing together here at Crufts.
Thank you. There you go, that
Carol
was
Carol Dodson and Brooklyn there. Now, that music gave me goosebumps, but how was the performance, Richard?
Yes, it was a bit more of a spooky performance, really, wasn't it? A different choice of music there, and that's the beauty about the sport, is you really can use very much different music, and it's really got to suit the team. Perhaps they didn't quite use that much of the ring, so the judges might have to take that into consideration. But there was, especially at the end there, a nice sort of independent bit where the dog went off and circled and the handler was sat on the box. And that shows good training, that the dog has been taught well to independently work from the handler.
Quite big props there. Do the handlers have to bring those with them in their own cars?
They do, and that's one consideration when I'm teaching people and we're developing routines. You have to think, how am I going to get this in the car? And so what you'll sometimes see is people have several different bits and they come and with their screwdrivers and they're putting it together at the competitions. Even some people have a little trailer on the back of the car, but it's always got to be relevant to the routine, though, as you can see. And the judges will be looking at as to whether or not that they are using those props effectively. If you're just using it once, the judges may not look at that as good.
So the more props isn't necessarily the merrier.
No, that's right. You could have a lot of props, but if you're not using them enough and they're not really reflecting your theme, that can detract from the prop use. I'm always looking to get at least two things with that prop, but preferably more.
Well, it looks like our results are in.
Yes, so a little bit lower again from Kat. She just seems to be a little bit lower, and that's the way when you're starting judging, you might just start that little bit lower. So you'll probably see her range of marks will be similar for everybody. We've got a little bit of a deduction there. Oh, a little bit higher. There's a maximum of 4 points that can be deducted for if there is noise. So that's possibly made her a little bit lower there. 22.10 and down to sixth place, unfortunately.
It really was an emotive performance, wasn't it, in terms of setting the atmosphere with that music?
That's right.
Our seventh competitor today is Leslie Neville with her dog Dewey. Dewey is a bearded collie, is the dog, and they're going to be performing to Tradition from Fiddler on the Roof, so another musical song here. They've had this partnership at Crufts for 6 years, so they are old hands in the big ring.
A fiddler on the roof. Sounds crazy, huh? But here in our little village of Anatevka, you might say every one of us is a fiddler on the roof, trying to scratch out a pleasant, simple tune without breaking his neck. It isn't easy. You may ask, why do we stay up there if it's so dangerous? How do we keep our balance? That I can tell you in one word, tradition.
Tradition!
Traditions. We've kept our balance for many, many years.
night must scramble for a living, feed the wife and children, say his daily prayers, and who has the right, as master of the house, to have the final word at home? The papa!
Traditions, traditions. Without our tradition, our lives would be as shaky as a fiddler on the roof.
Leslie Neville and Jimmy there. He was certainly showing off some of that typical beardy bounce, wasn't he?
Yes, definitely. Leslie always makes use of that beardy bounce with the jumps in her routine, and just like with her first dog Teddy, there was some nice interpretation of the music, especially where it went quieter, and you see how the moves were reflected with that. Obviously when the music was quieter she was doing less active moves, and that was why the piece of music was quite nice, because it had different speeds which she could then react to with her moves.
So how have the handlers who are here today, how have they got to this position?
Well, they've qualified up through various classes. We have starters, novice, intermediate, advanced, and have to qualify up through those classes into the advanced class, and then they get a qualifier at various shows throughout the year. There's semi-final qualifiers, and then they go to a semi-final, and they have to be in the top 10 to get here. So in a way, sometimes the semi-finals can be more nerve-wracking than this main ring, because at least here you've got to the top 10, and that's the final place. You know, you can say you were in Crufts 2020.
So judges just taking a little bit longer with this one.
Yes. Many things that they've got to take into consideration. There is 4 points under each of the sections, so they have to think about that. And here comes the scores. So we've got 8.5, 7.4, 7.6 for content. Accuracy and team performance, 8.3, 7.5 and 7.5. Interpretation, 8.6, 8, and 8 again. A little deduction there. That's obviously a little bit of squeaking, because it's not necessarily barking, it's noise. So that can take different forms. But in the third place is 23.50.
Respectable position there for them. And really, both of them so enthusiastic. Look like they've had a great day out.
And that's what we're always looking for. A team performance, dog and handler enjoying their time out there.
Next in the ring, we have Nikki Hidson and Elsa. So this is another border collie, a bitch, and she is 3 years old. They're going to be performing to Trip a Light Fantastic, another song from Mary Poppins. Nikki says that Elsa loves to dance, preferably at top speed.
Learys, trip the light to lead the way. Now when you're stuck in the mist, sure you can struggle and resist, or you can trip a little light fantastic with me.
Now say you're lost in the crowd. Well, you can stamp and scream out loud, or you can trip a little like fantastic with me. And when the fog comes rolling in, just keep your feet upon the path. Mustn't mope and frown, or worse, lie down. Don't let it be your epitaph. So when life is getting scary, be your own illuminary, who can shine the light for all the world to see. As you trip a little like fantastic with me. And if you're deep inside a tunnel and there is no end in sight, well, just carry on until the dawn. It's dark, it's right before the light. As you trip a little like fantastic, won't you trip a little like fantastic? Come on, trip a little like fantastic.
Now, that looked pretty fantastic to me. What do you reckon, Richard?
It was some lovely interpretation of the music there with a good range of moves. You saw some distance moves there where the dog was off round the lamppost there. And what I loved about that routine was you were looking at the dog, you know, and Nikki was there aiding the dog, bringing it alive. And yes, they were a team, but the focus was on the dog. And that's the most important thing when you watch a freestyle routine.
So they came second last year in the freestyle finals, and that was their first year. Do you think they could top it this year?
I think we'll see quite a high score coming in here. It's not Nikki's first time last year. She is an experienced handler. This is the third red and white border collie she's been in the main ring with. So she's also a young person who works in theatre productions as well, so she's got that side as well, the acting bit, and it really helped to sell this routine, and that's what they're doing when they're out there. They're selling the routine to the judges and the audience.
They've definitely won over the audience, so let's wait and see whether they've won over the judges as well. There we go, looks like they're coming in a second.
Yes, I think there's going to be some quite high scores here. Look at that,
wow.
Pamela 9.6, 8.2, and a 9. 8.8 for accuracy. 8.3. It was very fast and furious, so perhaps the accuracy is a little bit down because of that reason. I'm not sure. But interpretation had to be up quite high, and so 9.4 there from Pamela and a 9.2 from Dawn. This is looking good to go into the lead, I think. And yes, 26.63 into first place.
Fantastic achievement for them. I think well deserved, but we've still got two competitors to go, so let's wait and see.